This is an allegedly true story of questionable authenticity about the inventor of something very close to some people's lives. It's a song about a man named Otto Titsling. Otto Titsling, inventor and proud, had nothing to get very worked up about. His inventions were failures, his future seemed bleak. He fled to the opera at least twice a week. Then one night he saw an Aida, whose bust was so big it would often impede her. Bug eye, he watched her fall into the pit, down weighed by the weight of those terrible tits. Oh my gosh, there she goes, aerodynamically. This girl was a mess. Otto eyeballed his evil and comatose amongst the leaves, and suddenly the fire of inspiration flooded his soul, and he ran back to his workshop where he fussed, and he fussed, and he fussed. Well, Otto Titsling had found his quest to lift and mold the female dress, to point the small ones to the sky, and to keep searching for the right support. He tried some string and paper clips. Well, he even tried his own two lips. Well, he stitched and he slaved and he slaved and he stitched. And suddenly, in the wee hours of the morning, Otto arose from his workshop triumphant. He invented the world's first over-the-shoulder molder holder. Little did Otto know, at the moment of his greatest triumph, lurking under the diva's bed was none other than the very worst of the French patent thieves, Philippe de Brazier. And Phil was watching the scene with a great deal of interest. Later that night, while our hyena slept, into the wardrobe leap softly crept. He fumbled through knickers and corsets galore, till he found Otto's Titsling, and he ran out the door, crying, oh my God, what joy, what bliss, oh, I'm gonna make me a million from this. Every woman in the world will wanna buy one. I will have all the goods manufactured in Taiwan. The result of this swindle is pointedly clear. Do you buy a Titsling, or do you buy a Brazier?